And as the political situation in Maharashtra continues to remain uncertain, with the Shiv Sena BJP alliance unable to work out their differences, NCP and Congress are having a rethink about staking claim to form the government. Senior NCP leaders have said that Maharashtra governor should now invite the second largest alliance to form the government. Facing a crisis in the state unit, BJP has also called for a meeting of the core committee members to decide the way ahead. The term of the last assembly of Maharashtra expired last week, and the next government is yet to be sworn in, pushing the state closer to the possibility of a president's rule. Sena Chief Uddhav Thackeray continues to remain cautious over the deadlock with BJP, with party MLAs being secluded at a resort amidst the alleged poaching attempts by the BJP.
हमें लगता है कि ये काम 15 दिन पहले शुरू होना चाहिए था. देरी हुई है इसे सभी जानते हैं, लेकिन राज्यपाल महोदय को ये भी सुनिश्चित करना चाहिए कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के पास स्पष्ट बहुमत है कि नहीं. उनके साथी दल शिवसेना उनके साथ नहीं खड़े हैं. अगर फिर भी उन्हें मौका दिया जाता है तो निश्चित रूप से विधायकों की तोड़फोड़ और खरीद फरोख्त को कहीं ना कहीं बल मिलेगा. इस तरह का माहौल ना बने, राज्यपाल महोदय इसका ध्यान रखेंगे, हम आशा करते हैं.
उद्धव ठाकरे साहब ने और हमारे पार्टी की तरफ से हमने बार बार कहा है राज्य की अस्थिरता को खत्म करना है. इन 15 दिन के बाद अगर दावा पेश नहीं किया है तो राज्य में असमंजस और अस्थिरता की स्थिति पैदा हुई तो राज्यपाल को सक्रिय होना पड़ा है. ये राज्यपाल संविधान के मुताबिक राज्यपाल ने ये कदम उठाया और हम उनका स्वागत करते हैं.
My colleague Chaitanya is joining us on the broadcast. Chaitanya, help us understand, is it completely for certain, is it that the BJP Shiv Sena alliance is not working out? Could there be a rethink from the NCP side? Is that something that you're expecting?
Well, as of now, it is quite difficult to say anything because everything depends on the position of BJP, which will be clear by 8 p.m. tomorrow, that is 11th of November. And based on that is what NCP, Shiv Sena, as well as Congress will decide. Now, there are several meetings that are being carried out at present. If we have to talk about, one meeting is going on at Varsha Bungalow, which is the official residence of Chief Minister. So the core committee of BJP is meeting there to decide as to what steps they have to take, because they have been invited as the single largest party by the governor to form the government. Now, it depends on them whether they are able to prove the majority, whether they are able to prove their numbers. On the other hand, it is Shiv Sena, which is having a meeting at Hotel Retreat. Uddhav Thackeray has reached at Hotel Retreat and is meeting all his MLAs along with Aditya Thackeray and trying to find out as to what the MLAs are looking at and what are they expecting from their party leader. And now third meeting, if you have to talk about, is going on at Jaipur of the all the Congress MLAs as well as the state leaders of the Congress who are also at the hotel in Jaipur. And there is a discussion going on as to what can be the next step that can be taken by the Congress if BJP fails to prove its majority, BJP fails to form a government in the state. So all these speculations as of now are all going on, but then most of these parties have adopted wait and watch policy because it is the first chance given to the BJP. In fact, NCP has already called a meeting on 12th of November, that is day after tomorrow, to see to it that what steps they can take depending on the decision or depending on the stand that BJP is going to take tomorrow by 8 p.m. So all everything, in fact, at this point of time is connected to each and every party. So depending on what one party decides, the other party is going to take a stand. However, NCP has been saying that when BJP has been invited by the governor at a time when they do not have numbers and it is clear, then it is likely that the BJP may get into horse trading, and that is the reason the governor should first confirm if the BJP has 145 seats or more to prove their majority and form the government in the state, and then allow them to form a government in the state.
Clearly, there is an atmosphere of uncertainty and mistrust that exists, not just between BJP and Shiv Sena. We're not certain, Chaitanya, as you're pointing out, what may happen with the NCP and the Congress. What is the status of the Congress MLAs? Are they still all at a resort in Jaipur? That's where they moved all the MLAs earlier?
Well, yes, the report that we are getting from several Congress leaders is that all these MLAs are at that hotel in Jaipur, and there is also meeting which is going on. In fact, from almost 2 hours now that the Congress leaders of the state are there. In fact, we have also reports that some of the Congress leaders also met Congress leader Sonia Gandhi in the center, and then they have also requested her to look into it and see as to what options they can come up with. In fact, there are also talks that the control of Congress at this point of time should also be given to Sharad Pawar, who is the head of NCP at this point of time, to decide as to what will be the best in the state and what these two parties, if they come together, can do, whether they can get numbers. Because NCP has been saying that if Shiv Sena fails, or if BJP fails, in fact, to prove their majority, and if Shiv Sena doesn't support them, then it should be the NCP and Congress, which is the second biggest alliance, which should be allowed to come forward and form a government if possible in the state. So that is what they're also looking at, if they can gather numbers. So everyone, in fact, at this point of time, trying to do their own calculations.
Thank you, Chaitanya, for putting that story in perspective. Let's now move on and talk